Morning! Hello and welcome to a new Walt Disney World vlog. Today I'm heading to Epcot for Food and Wine Festival with my friend Richard and then heading over to Mickey's Not So Scary Halloween Party at Magic Kingdom.
The camera lens is not liking the humidity today. Hi, good morning. Thank you.
I've just entered in through the International Gateway, which is the back entrance to Epcot. So if you're staying at the Yacht Club, the Beach Club, the Boardwalk, Swan and Dolphin, Pop Century, Caribbean Beach, Art of Animation, you're coming through this way to Epcot. International Gateway arrives halfway between the United Kingdom and France. I'm meeting up with Richard in World Celebration, and if you've watched my recent Epcot vlogs, you know that I absolutely love this music. It's so nice. He's picked me up at Starbucks, which is very nice of him. And then we're going to go ride Guardians at Galaxy Cosmic Rewind, which we've got a single pass for. Richard's back, everybody!
Oh, hello!
And he's the kind bearer of coffee this morning, so he gets 10 points to the house of your choosing.
Ravenclaw,
there you go. We're going to go and have a look at the Communicore, which has got a Food and Wine Festival pop-up in it, and some air conditioning, which would be appreciated. In the very nicely air-conditioned Communicore Hall, we have two Food and Wine Festival stands. You've got one that's, I think, for serving drinks, and one that's serving a menu. And then you've got a small Food and Wine Festival merchandise pop-up. We've got a lounge fly this year. There's a very nice apron there. A plate. A tank top. Plush. Oven mitts, tea towels, a Figment spirit jersey, a Figment shirt, corksicle. Nice, if you like Figment, Food and Wine Festival is the thing for you. If you ever have any problems with lightning lanes, the multi-pass or single-pass service, go to the blue umbrellas and the cast members who are the guest experience team and they'll be able to help you. I had an issue a few days ago where I'd come through with a different park pass and then all my lightning lanes had disappeared, and so they were able to restore them from there.
Time to defend the galaxy!
So, you can bring drinks into the lines at Disney. You just have to finish them before you get to like the batching area. Have you done this trip yet?
Not on this trip, no.
Yeah. I'm excited. Okay, so I'm hoping for Disco Inferno. What are you hoping for?
Conga!
Conga! Come on everybody, do the conga!
Dangerous without a
rope. Very intense. For you to travel to Xandar would take 2.5 million years, assuming you had a ship that could fly at the speed of light. So we decided to come to you.
Brush up the salmon, brush up the salmon.
I love the noise of like electric motors on rides.
That's very niche.
It's a very niche thing, but like that, it's like a high pitch, like that noise.
I love fun it. Is coming.
Yeah.
Oh, that noise is the good stuff.
Bags go on the floor, loose items go in the pocket. Sit down.
What have we done?
I think we jumped back.
Conga! Woo!
Generator is the only way back.
There it is! We got the generator!
Party. See the break of day.
have ferns. Crazy things.
Are you crying as well?
Yeah. Woohoo! Oh, so good.
Welcome to the Guardians of the Galaxy.
We have no room in our ship for these new cars.
Drax, it's an honorary title. They're not coming with us.
I see. It was meaningless.
Well, then welcome to the Guardians of the Galaxy. Now, where's that cake toast?
Where does it come on your scale of favorite rides in Disney World?
Three.
Number three. What's number two? What's number one?
Tiana's is now number one for the moment, I think.
Okay, yeah.
And then it's probably a toss up between this and Flight of Passage, like two and three, like sort of fluctuate depending on my mood for the day.
It's funny, everyone's motion sickness seems to be different because some people go on that and be really motion sick.
Yes.
I am the type of like 3D glasses.
Okay.
So if I go on Flight of Passage, I'm like, yeah, I need to sit down, but on that one I'm fine because I'm moving.
See, I'm that one. That one makes me
makes you queasy.
Yeah. The tip is, depending on what makes you sick, when you're going that bit where it like loops around the moon.
Yes.
Don't look at the moon.
Don't look
like,
at the moon.
Look at the seat in front of you for that bit because it's like a static point. Because the moon bit will just, it makes me go.
As well as the single pass that we booked, we also used the multi-pass to make selections for Spaceship Earth, Frozen, and the Seas with Nemo and Friends. You might notice, the good thing about the new system is you can slightly overlap return times by 20 minutes. So even though we want to do Spaceship Earth after Frozen, we can do that. Ride Frozen first, and then go to Spaceship Earth. Disney gives you 5 minutes before and 15 minutes after any return time to use your window. It is that sort of hot to the point where I need the 1-2 Beyonce fan. Oh, it does help.
Oh yes, the breeze.
With soft and bouncy hair. We are going the right way around World Showcase, and I say the right way because we're technically going to the right. Do you go clockwise or anti-clockwise? I'd love to know. But for me, this is how I used to walk to work when I worked at the Rose and Crown, did the exchange program there. And it just makes me feel like I'm going back to work, but in a nice way, not like a, oh, I've got to go to work today. We've already passed Hawaii and the Shimmering Sips stand without even looking at the menus because I think we're both walking towards the same thing.
Canada. Soup.
What do you want?
Soup. Get me that soup.
The cheese soup. This is Memorial Day Monday. The lines are really not that bad first thing in the morning. This is about 12. And if you're on the dining plan, these class as dining plan credits. That's pretty good. If you get a dining plan credit for $9.75, that's a really good use of a dining
credit. Credit.
Yeah. We had a nice conversation with the guy at the register about Tesco meal deals. That's something I didn't think I was talking about in Epcot.
No. Food and Wine Festival and we're talking about sandwiches and crisps.
You get your receipt and hand it to the next cast member at the window and then they will get your food for you. A very nice couple gave us their table, so we have set ourselves up with cheese soups and the filet mignon.
And the filet mignon.
Big filet mignon. But we've got this gorgeous view over the lagoon as well. But I am very excited to try this for the first time in a long time. I think the last time I had this was actually in the restaurant. Nearly went on my fan. Oh, that's the good stuff.
Yeah. The bread is also pretzel bread.
The pretzel bread is very good as well. This is the dish that every year consistently gets a 5 out of 5 from me. Richard's about to delve into his filet mignon.
We just keep saying it.
We just change the name every time. I would just like to clarify my star rating. So I rate everything I do out of 5. 5 obviously being like above and beyond, this is amazing. 4 is like, this was good. 3 is it met the standard and like the expectation. 2 is like, I would personally wouldn't have it again, but it might be right for someone. And 1 is like, hard pass. Like, wouldn't recommend this to most people.
What would you say, Richard? A 5.
A 5?
Yeah, it's better than last night. The meat is really tender. It's a bit hard to cut with a plastic knife, but I appreciate that.
Do they cook it at a certain temperature?
It seems to be, I'd say that's like medium, maybe towards medium rare. Comes with mashed potatoes. The butter has like a Boursin cheese in it as well.
Ooh.
So it's like, yeah, that's just good stuff all round.
I won't be trying it because it has mushrooms.
Just don't eat them. We don't eat them.
I'm not sure we'll pick up on camera, but we can literally see the rain coming across the lagoon right now. Rain plan, everyone. Get your flip-flops out. Don't panic! Here it comes! At least you won't get a soaking shirt this time. Now with your new poncho. How much was your poncho? Oh, because you bought the t-shirt at the same time.
It was one of those situations where I was like, just give. Just
and give. That's what Disney likes. We've sheltered for a few minutes, and just like that, it is back to being dry. Welcome to Florida, everybody.
For now.
If you want the best popcorn in all of Walt Disney World, here it is, maple popcorn. If you're visiting at this time of year, where it is like hot, really, really hot, I recommend popping into Race Against the Sun. It's a nice little museum thing that no one ever thinks to go in because it doesn't look like anything, but it is air conditioned and you can play a little car game with the kids and sit down on a bench and just chill. It's very nice and cool in here. Little exhibit. This is one of my favorite spots when it's raining. Just sit on the bench. Just watch it pour through the ceiling. Very zen. Very mindful. Very demure. Do you get it? No?
I get it.
You get it? You get it? But you're embarrassed?
Yes.
Yeah. So, yeah, I'm sorry. Do you need to pee yet?
Yes.
I love the Japan Pavilion. Aircon! Tell me what you just said.
So it's key rings of cats as sushi, but the cat on the front is like, why am I sushi?
And it's got a tear coming down its face.
I love this.
We're just passing the pearl thing. I've never done it, and I really want to do it. So, we're gonna do it. One oyster experience is $31.
So this is your second trip. Please come to the center.
Arigato gozaimasu. Hi. So choose the oyster. I've got a good feeling about this one.
This one. Right. Please come back to the center. Before we open, let's perform a Japanese greeting together. Please do as I do like this. Take a bow with me. Irasshaimase, welcome to Japan. Thank you very much. Please give them a round of applause. Please come. 3, 2, 1, in Japanese together.
Okay, san ni ichi.
Yes, perfect. How do you know that?
I'm learning Japanese.
Alright, let's count that.
San ni ichi.
I'm quite your pro. You are is right here.
Oh wow! That's pretty big.
Congratulations, it's beautiful. Now let's measure the size of your pro. Start from 6.5, 6.75. Going 7.25. You got 7.25.
Thank you. Congratulations. So once you've got your pearl, you can then turn it into some beautiful jewelry.
Yes. Necklace
case settings.
Arigato gozaimasu.
Arigato gozaimasu. Ooh, very nice.
Thank you.
Which is your favorite?
My favorite is this one because it's quite simple, but then there's a shiny.
Shiny?
Yeah. I love shiny bling bling.
They did have some nice jewelry there, and it was, they weren't expensive, but they were a bit feminine for me. But they did say just hold on to the pearl with the measurement on it. And that way you can bring it back in the future and get a piece of jewelry if you want to. So, you know, if I ever find a man who likes something sparkly. These Buddha boards are very popular. You take this little brush and you write your wishes and dreams. I'm going to draw a Mickey Mouse. And then a pound sign for riches. Got lots of Japanese food in here, so if you wanted to get something from Japan without going all the way to Japan, this is the place to do it. I had a family member that went to Tokyo recently and they said that matcha Kit Kats are like the best thing ever. They have them here, so I'm going to treat her to it.
Kit Kat, $12.95.
$12.95 for those Kit Kats. I did try the matcha pocky with my friends at Cheers Ears, and I like matcha, but that just tastes like grass. more liquid sunshine. That's quite nice.
That one.
Yeah, Cinderella.
That is, I really like this one. I like the sort of like old school
graphic art print, yeah, poster like thing.
The old school tourism vibe.
And most pictures in Disney are $399. Don't ask me why, but if they're about that size and they have a frame, they're about $400. Slowly making our way around the world. We did just see a very big bolt of lightning.
Yeah.
We seem to be not having a great time with the weather at the moment.
It's what we get for complaining that it's so hot.
Oh, I'll cool you down, alright.
Yeah. The universe saying, you don't want it, have this instead.
We have arrived in China, and we're going to hide from the rain for a bit before our lightning lane frozen in the reflections of China. We've got a seating area before the show, so if you need to sit down, there's some aircon, nice place to come. And then they have the Inside Shanghai Disney Resort. So if you want like a little sneak peek of what's available in Shanghai, you can kind of have a little Moo Moo Shiroo. You've got a look at the Zootopia land they just built. This is cool.
Yeah, this is cool.
Hello everyone, in Hong Kong, my name is Marty and I'm from China.
This is a 360 cinema experience. If you come right to the end, they do have some seats. Oh. And that way you don't have to turn your head so much. These are prioritised for guests with disabilities though, but on a quiet day like this.
Eating, drinking, smoking, or whatever. Thank you.
Just me? Okay.
Ah, China. When one thinks of this magnificent country, one cannot help but envision the Wanli Changcheng, the Great Wall. When Marco Polo traveled this way, he called Suzhou the Venice of the East.
As you exit, you come into the shop and the House of Good Fortune. It's a very good advert for China.
It is a very good advert for China. It looks like a beautiful country.
And this is the store where you can make an offering to Buddha as well. Buddha, now available in LED. You can have a little garden that you rake to make nice patterns.
Very zen.
It is actually very therapeutic, you know. Good use of a lightning lane today. My goodness. This says it's only 45 minutes, but I think that might be longer. Big step.
Thank you.
home again, jiggity jig.
Passing through the old Odyssey Pavilion, which is now Brew Wing. So I think they have all different types of wings in here. Traditional buffalo wings, peanut butter and jelly sticky wings. Oh my goodness. Goodness me, she knows how to pronounce her number.
Okay, I'm coming.
Bingo! Another nice place to sit down. Just gonna cut through the creation shop. We're heading towards Spaceship Earth now. Oh, they're fun. Bottle stoppers,
yeah. Nice.
We've got this nice plain Walt Disney World collection.
That's quite nice, actually.
If you want basics, yeah. No mullet shirt, which I appreciate.
Yeah.
These nice colourful jumpers. And this is good to clarify as well. Disneyland is the happiest place on Earth. Walt Disney World is the most magical place on Earth. Look, they've got the entry sign ears.
Ah, right.
Ah, $34.99. Hooray! There is a hidden Mickey in this mural. It's not very obvious. It is the negative space of the three.
Inside the people, and please.
This Egyptian at the back is a former president from the Hall of Presidents in Magic Kingdom. And Joe Rohde actually used his face as the cast for this animatronic right here.
Remember how easy it was to learn your ABCs? Thank the Phoenicians. They invented it.
Walt Disney Imagineering used to be called Walt Disney Productions, but when they turned it to Walt Disney Imagineering, this used to say WDP as like a little Easter egg, so they had to just put a bit of black tape over the P to make it an I.
After 30,000 years of time travel, here we are, a truly global community, poised to shape the future of this, our spaceship Earth. Welcome to the future, or should I
say, your future? Oh good,
oh, I got a big hole in the head.
Now that's a smart look.
Your doors will open automatically.
I see you.
Whee! Richard and I are heading back to our respective resorts to have a little afternoon chill before Mickey's Not So Scary. We're also not planning on going there until it starts about 7. I've noticed that whilst you can go in early with a Mickey's Not So Scary Halloween party ticket, that transition from like day guests to the party is very, very busy. So we're gonna wait until it's actually up and running. Bye, thank you. One thing I noticed about going to the Food and Wine Festival in the heat like this, my appetite went way down. Like, we literally ate that cheese soup and I was like, I'm full, you know, didn't need anything more than that. I have noticed I am a little bit more hungry now that I'm heading back to the resort, so I'm gonna see if there is something in the ice cream parlor that I might like. This used to be the location of the ESPN bar. This is gonna be the Cake Bake Shop, which I do believe has other locations in the US and is much anticipated. It looks very fancy. Boardwalk ice cream. Ooh, they have sundaes. Look at this. Okay, I got the Surf's Up sundae, which is two scoops of ice cream and a choice of topping. I got hot fudge and then a whipped cream, toasted almonds and chocolate chips. And it was $7.49, not bad.
I am several spoons into this, and this is probably the best sundae I've ever had. The ice cream is very good, the hot fudge is delicious, and I think for, you know, $7.50, pretty good.
My hair is real right now. It's about 3:30, so I've got a few hours until I need to meet Richard again. I'm gonna take this time to catch up with some work I have to do and cool down. And I'm gonna meet Richard about 7 p.m. for Mickey's Not So Scary, but I do have a nice, fun outfit to wear, so I'm gonna turn into that now. Aha! Spooky vibes! I have got my new shirt that I bought whilst on this trip. I have my crow from the Haunted Mansion. the jack-o'-lantern ears and also the jack-o'-lantern necklace. Some of these items were previously gifted from a collaboration with Disney Store, so previously ad gifted. I'm now going to make my way over to the bus and turn this on when it gets nice and dark and enjoy some nice Halloween times at Magic Kingdom. I've decided I'm only going to wear the ears for photos, so they're going to go in my bag, but I've also got an umbrella with me because the weather, we're not sure what's going to happen tonight. Sometimes during Mickey's Not So Scary, if it does rain during the party, they will sometimes delay certain things. It's a bit touch and go. You can dress up in full Halloween costumes for Mickey's Not So Scary Halloween Party. There are some guidelines which I recommend checking on the Walt Disney World website, but some basic things are you can't have anything overly gory. It is a not so scary Halloween party, not a scary Halloween party. And also you can't have masks that cover your face entirely, but you can have face paint and that sort of thing. What's in there?
Ooh, that's fun.
Very cool.
And now we invite you to the box and join the ride of Magic Kingdom. Just beware of the driving ghosts.
If you're arriving after the party has started, after 7 p.m, make sure you, not now, if you go to the sign, because you need to scan in a particular space to get your park ticket and wristband.
I have the crow.
That's so nice.
I've called him Desmond.
Good, that's a good name for a crow. Honestly.
Thank you so much.
It's so sweet.
It's slightly sinister, you know?
Yeah. Yay, okay.
Thank
and
you.
Then your wristband for the night or just at the head, friend?
Thank you.
Have a great night.
Hey, how are you?
Good, how are you?
Great. There you go.
Thank you very much. Have a nice day.
Sing over the copyright because it's copyright. And if I don't do this, you won't see what's going on. As you enter the party, you're gonna turn to the right.
Wristbands at this time.
Wristbands! Here we go. I've been found by a ghoul!
Wasn't that the best surprise? Oh, I know. No one's ever expecting it. What?
Ah!
That was the right spot. Try that again.
Sorry.
Ready?
Woo!
Oh, yes, third time's the trick.
Instead of getting your bags down there, you now go through Tomorrowland Terrace as you arrive and pick up your first load of treats and your bag. Hi, thank you so much. Ooh, I like these. Trick or treat! Thank you. Sing over the copyright, whoa. Here I was thinking I'd be original, you know, get the special Halloween shirt. There's a lot of people wearing this shirt. I think I've seen 7 so far. If you have any trouble getting on Tiana's Bayou Adventure, but you're coming to Mickey's Not So Scary Halloween Party, it is a standby wait during the party, so you can just line up and have a drop. Also look out for the treats, big pylons. You'll be able to get some trick-or-treating there. Typically, they're very busy at the beginning of the party, and then once everyone's kind of like done it for a couple of hours, they're like, eh, we're done. That's when you can go trick-or-treat and then just go round and round and round and round and round and round and round. You might think, oh, the sun's gone down, it must be cool now. Absolutely not. Liza Minnelli.
Because this year's the wildest ride in the wilderness!
Yee-haw! And now we sit here in awkward silence whilst we wait to dispatch. Okay, Richard? Oh, you okay?
you okay?
I'm looking indecent.
Darkness has fallen across the land, which means I need to turn on my lanyard. Woo! There's a bit too much. I don't want to be obnoxious with my flashing. Ooh. Trick or treat! Well, Richard went to the toilet. Did I go around that trick or treat stop four times? Yes, I did. I'm nearly there.
It is 8:15.
8:15, so the party's been going on for an hour and 15 minutes, and the lines are all gone for trick or treating. Hi!
Hello!
Trick or treat!
Hello! Happy Halloween!
Happy Halloween to you!
Thank you.
Oh, I thought you were filming something over there.
If anyone in your party happens to have any allergies to candy, for example, for peanuts, as you go through there, ask for an allergy token. You can then take that to the ticket office in Liberty Square and exchange them for allergy-friendly treats. Learn from our mistakes. When the first parade is on, do not go anywhere near the Liberty Bell. Don't do it. It's very, very congested. We kind of got trapped because of the first parade going on. So we're going to kill some time in the Critter Co-op. Oh, and it's air-conditioned. Do not mind if I do. Ooh, cooking up a stew. Oh, wow, that's cool. I love that. How much is that? That is $249 plus tax. Is this from Louisiana? Leah Chase. Yeah, New Orleans.
Very nice.
Part of the fabric of New Orleans.
Gumbo base. Nice.
It says Tiana's Bayou Adventure is a 50-minute wait. We're not sure it is, because people have been prevented from getting here because of the parade. So we're just going to risk it for a chocolate biscuit. And we'll register the time now, which is...
Starting a stopwatch.
Starting a stopwatch? Oh, Richard's the professional. The good thing is there's no lightning lane, so it should move quicker. Our tickets for Mickey's Not So Scary Halloween Party tonight were $119. They're cheaper at the beginning of the season, and then as you get closer to Halloween, they go up to $199 plus tax.
That's actually really good. It's worth just standing in it.
Is it?
That's good.
We're going up the stairs. The stopwatch is on 8:42, so, I mean, I don't think it's 50 minutes.
No, I don't think we've got another 42 minutes from here.
The parade is obviously finished and the line is getting longer, but I mean, during the first parade is a good opportunity to come and ride this if you can get in before the line gets cut off. Go and do Big Thunder Mountain if the parade is about to start, then come and do this because then the line's thinned out a bit and no one can get here. Go into the salt mine, go into the salt mine, go into the salt mine, we might get wet. Oh, the fireflies!
Look at all these beautiful faces! Find some new fishes for our hearts. We're going to the Banbury. Woohoo!
Richard tried to do grumpy Splash Mountain lady, but
I'm just a bit more disinterested.
At the Golden Oak Outpost, they have an exclusive sweet and spicy beignets. Ooh, should we try them?
Yes.
Why not? These are the sweet and spicy beignets. As far as I know, these are not fried. The only fried ones are available at Pauline's French Quarter. It's like a raspberry donut.
It's really odd.
Yeah.
Like, the spice is just there underneath. Yeah. It like comes in at the end.
I'm gonna give them a 3.
Yeah. I was gonna say like 2.5, 3. Like, are they better than like normal beignets?
No. One more treat stop, and then we'll be getting a spot for the fireworks that start at 10 p.m. It's not like normal fireworks shows like Happy Ever After and stuff. You can definitely get a spot like 10, 20 minutes before and still get a very good view.
Halloween is a night filled with surprises. Playful tricks, frightful treats. What? Anything can happen on Halloween.
I think Zero wants us to wallow in the dirt. Van Hounds!
That house doesn't look very inviting!
I feel like everyone has the same idea as us, but it's okay. We gotta do it. Have some photo opportunities. I can say at the end of the party these look very, very empty, and we're now going to get a spot for the 11:15 parade. The second parade is always a little bit quieter than the first parade. This was a sold out party. It is Memorial Day, so it's just been a very busy day all around, but yeah, we'll leave it at that. Because it is a busy party, we are struggling to find a spot on Main Street, which was our original plan. So we're now calling in the Christmas shop treat. Treat? Trick. Tip? I don't know, it's tired. I'm tired. It's late? I'm tired. I'm Adam. Hello, how are you? Don't forget to subscribe. Quality content here.
This is what you subscribe
this
for.
This is what you get. Can we get a picture of the poison? Thanks. 10 minutes before parade start, this is what I managed to get.
Greetings!
The real star of Mickey's Not So Scary Halloween Party is coming. The chicken!
You get some candy! You get some candy! Everybody gets some candy!
That's going to do it for Mickey's Not So Scary Halloween Party 2024 with Adam and Richard. I had a good time. I think with the heat, it was a bit more difficult. We had to kind of like...
Pace ourselves.
We haven't done everything. Like, we're not going to be able to see the Hocus Pocus show unless we, you know, really, really push through. We've had a good run. I think it definitely worked with the heat not coming until it had started. That was a good move. But we've had a good time. You had a good time?
I have had a good time.
It was $119 for us each. Was it worth the price tag?
I think if you haven't been to one of the parties before, like you're on a trip,
yep,
do it.
Yeah.
I think if you've been to one of the parties before, especially recently, you can maybe like skip a couple of years.
Yeah. We were talking about that. Like, you don't. It's not the type of thing you have to do every year. Some people ask how it compares to the Christmas party. I personally prefer the Christmas party.
Agree. Second that. Yeah.
The candy is like a good benefit here. At the Christmas party, you get cookies and hot chocolate and stuff. Yeah. But the atmosphere and the vibe of the Christmas party is my fave. If you're exiting Magic Kingdom whilst the parade is on, make sure you stay on the left-hand side of the street because the parade wraps around, and if you're on the right, you'll get stuck there. As you can tell by my extra fluffy hair, I'm done. One thing I will do after Mickey's Not So Scary Halloween Party and Mickey's Very Merry Christmas Party is I will order a minivan to take me back to the resort. This is Disney's like private Lyft Uber service, and they have like a fun design. They are more expensive than a traditional Uber or Lyft, but they will pick you up right from the Magic Kingdom bus station right there, which is a huge benefit when everybody's gonna be rushing to the bus at the same time. Minivans pick up from bus stop one here at Magic Kingdom. They take a while to arrive typically after parties because that's when they're most busy. I will normally order it when I'm like in the hub and just check how long it's going to take. Today it was going to take 14 minutes and it's bang on time. It's taken me 14 minutes to walk from there out to here whilst the parade is on as well. And I can literally see my one arriving over there. You can order minivans through the Lyft app. Hi, just me.
Perfect. How are you doing tonight?
Very warm. How are you?
I'm good. Thank you.
Come on in.
Thank you.
And he said just you tonight?
Just me.
Nice. Love your shirt, by the way.
Thank you. I bought it myself.
You're welcome.
Is minivan driving guests to the airport and back now?
In a small bracket. Not all everybody like we used to before COVID. If you are staying at a deluxe Disney resort and at club level, then you can take our air service to and from the airport as long as it's booked 24 hours ahead of time or more.
Only club level?
Yeah. Okay. So if you are ever able to treat yourself coming back and splurge a little bit on that, then you can totally use our service to and from.
Sweet, sweet teleportation. Oh. That minivan is, it's a very nice treat. It really is. That was a $43 trip, and I tipped on top of that. So it is a treat yourself moment. I definitely wouldn't recommend it for every single trip you're gonna do around Walt Disney World property. That would amount up very, very quickly. And sometimes actually the buses do beat the minivans in terms of like the wait time for minivans and stuff. But if you plan ahead in exiting something so busy like the parties and stuff, come in very, very, very handy. Home sweet home. Oh, I've had a long and hot day, but I'm gonna have a nice shower, get this eyeliner off, and go to bed to be dead to the world. Mickey's Not So Scary Halloween Party was a good time. I had fun. It did feel very busy this evening, but it was Memorial Day, which is a federal holiday here in the US. So bear that in mind if you're visiting on Memorial Day or another bank holiday during a party. You have two main events that are like this. Mickey's Not So Scary Halloween Party, which runs from September through to October, and Mickey's Very Merry Christmas Party, which runs November through to December. There are also after-hours events that run at other times during the year, and people often ask me, like, which do you prefer? I personally prefer Mickey's Very Merry Christmas Party over Not So Scary, because they just have different vibes. You know, Christmas is more about sentimental and friends and family and stuff, whilst Not So Scary is more about, you know, dressing up and candy and that sort of thing. So, you know, take your pick as to which one is going to be right for you. The after-hours events I've done previously and actually really enjoyed as well. So if you don't happen to be visiting during the holiday season, there are other options for lower crowds and being able to do rides that would otherwise be, you know, virtual queue or something. So that was probably my favourite thing about the Not So Scary Party tonight, was the fact that Tiana's Bayou Adventure and Tron were just standby waits. You didn't have to virtual queue it. The only thing, we didn't manage to do everything. We didn't manage to do the Hocus Pocus show that they do on the castle, but we had kind of accepted that we were going to have to give something up in the night. You know, you can do everything in terms of like entertainment shows, trick-or-treating, etc. But if you do want to do the rides like Tiana's and Tron, you're going to have to give up something. And we chose to give up Hocus Pocus because we've seen it before. But otherwise, I hope you've enjoyed watching. If you want to check out Richard's channel, he is Richard Vlogs Disney on YouTube. There is a link in the description. I will next be back with some other vlog friends that you might recognize. And I hope you will join me for then. So in the meantime, like this video if you enjoyed it. Subscribe to the Future Chef. Thank you so much for watching, and I'll see you next time.